We were doing the topic chemical bonding. In chemical bonding, we have covered up ionic bond formation. Now we are doing the covalent bond formation. Ionic bond will form between the metal and the non-metal, while covalent bond will form between the non-metal atoms. Because in case of metals, metals lose electrons and non-metals gain electrons. So ionic bond will form by the loss of electrons by metal and by gaining of those electrons by non-metals. While when the two non-metal atoms are there, both of these atoms, they need electrons. So what they will do, they will form a covalent bond in which mutual sharing of electrons will take place. So a covalent bond will form when a non-metal reacts with non-metal. So this is formed between non-metal and non-metal. And how they are reacting? By mutual sharing of electron. The word mutual, it has to be there in this definition. By mutual sharing of electrons. And they will form a bond. And this bond is known as covalent bond. So the bond that is formed by mutual sharing of electrons between two non-metal atoms, that bond is known as covalent bond. Now further, these bonds are of three types. The covalent bonds are of three types. These three types of covalent bonds are single covalent bond, then double covalent bond, and third one is triple covalent bond. So next is, what is a single covalent bond? In case of single covalent bond, when mutual sharing of electrons will take place between the two atoms, one electron pair will be there which is involved in mutual sharing. So see, what is a single covalent bond? A single covalent bond is formed by, this bond is formed by mutual sharing of one electron pair between two atoms, and it is represented by a single line. Single covalent bond is represented by a single line between the two atoms. Which two atoms? Which are sharing electrons. So to understand this now, example, what is covalent bond and what is single covalent bond will be clear from this example. First example I'm taking is formation of H2. Simple example, formation of H2 molecule. So how H2 molecule formation takes place? For this, we are again using the Lewis symbols here. Hydrogen and hydrogen, two hydrogen atoms, non-metal atoms, how they are combining with each other. In the Lewis symbol, they have one electron in the last shell. Now both these atoms, they need one more electron to have a stable nearest noble gas configuration, that is of helium, and they will try to complete their duplet. Now see, if this atom needs one more electron for stability, and this also needs one more atom to have stability, so what they will do, if both the atoms need electron, then they will share those many number of electrons with other atom. So if it is sharing one electron, this also has to share one electron. That is why we use the word mutual sharing. Mutual sharing means same number of electrons will come from both the atoms for sharing. So when this is sharing one electron with this hydrogen atom, this electron that is shared with this one, this will come in the center. center means this is not now belonging to this atom only, this electron belongs to both these atoms. Since this hydrogen has given one electron in sharing, this also has to give this one electron in sharing. So this also is giving one in the sharing. So these electrons which are coming now in the center in the sharing, these electrons, they belong to both the hydrogen atoms, and that we show like this, making a circle around this, that shows that these two electrons are with this hydrogen. So this is stable by having two electrons. Similarly, this hydrogen also has these two electrons. So this also is stable. In the sharing, in this overlapping part, how many electrons are there? One pair, one electron pair when it is there, then between the two atoms, which kind of bond will form? That is a single bond will form, single covalent bond, shown by a single line. One electron pair in sharing means we show it like this. So between the two atoms, which type of bond is formed? That is a single covalent bond is formed. So how single covalent bond is formed? The bond that is formed by sharing of one electron pairs between the two atoms, that is called a single covalent bond. Some more examples for single covalent bond, and then we'll move on to the double covalent bond. Example 2. Formation of Cl2. Again, both the atoms here are of the same element only, that is Cl, Lewis symbol of chlorine atoms. This has 7 electrons in its last shell. In chlorine, there are 7 electrons in last shell because atomic number is 17. Electronic configuration is 2, 8, 7 electrons in last shell. So these are the Lewis symbols of chlorine atoms. Now, how many electrons are required by the Cl to have stable electronic configuration? This needs one more electron. This also needs one more electron. So what they will do? Now, this Cl is sharing one electron. This one electron it is giving in the sharing in the center. That means this Cl also has to give this electron in the sharing. So one electron this atom is giving in sharing, one this will give in the sharing. And as a result of this, now these 6 electrons, they will remain with these Cl. But these are involved in the sharing, that is in the bonding. These 2 electrons are belonging to this Cl also. And these 2 electrons are belonging to this Cl atom also. As a result of this, just see in this circle how many electrons are coming, 8. So this Cl is stable. Even in this circle, there are 8 electrons coming. So this Cl is also stable. And now in the sharing part, how many electrons are there? 2 electrons. That means between 2 Cl atoms, a single covalent bond will form. These electrons which are in the sharing part, these electron pairs, these are called bond pairs because they are involved in the bonding. So this is called bond pairs electron. And these electrons of last shell of these atoms which are not involved in the bonding, these are called non-bonded electrons or called lone pair of electrons. Lone pair or non-bonded electrons. They are not involved in the bonding. So this is how the formation of chlorine molecule will take place. Next example. Formation of HCl. Now the 2 atoms here, I'm taking of the different elements. One is hydrogen, another one is the Cl. So first of all, Lewis symbol of hydrogen and of the Cl. Hydrogen has 1 electron in its last shell, while Cl has 7 electrons in its last shell. Now, in this case, both these atoms, again, they need how many electrons to have stability? This also needs 1 electron. This also needs 1 electron. So, if they need 1 electron, how many they will share? 1 electron they will share, hydrogen and Cl. So, this 1 electron, this is sharing. This will share this electron. So, these 2 electrons will come in center and Cl is left with these 6 electrons. So, now, in the sharing part, hydrogen has got 2 electrons. It's stable. And Cl has got 8 electrons, so Cl is also stable. And as a result of this, now between the two, H and Cl, one electron pair is there, that means a single covalent bond will form between two atoms, hydrogen and Cl. This is how the formation of HCl takes place. Example 4. Formation of H2O. Now I'm taking more than two atoms, three atoms I'm taking. In these three examples, we had taken HH, Cl, Cl, HNCl, two atoms in a molecule. But now two atoms of hydrogen, one of oxygen, there are three atoms. So first of all, when we have more than two atoms, the important thing is we should know placement of these atoms. Where we should place oxygen and where we should place hydrogen, that is called their skeletal structure. Mostly here hydrogen will always towards the extreme end. Or the simple way to understand here is the atom which is in lesser number, that will come in center, and around that we will have other atoms. So hydrogen will always towards extreme end, and in center we will place oxygen. This placement of atoms, first of all, should be clear. If there is a mistake in writing the atoms, their position, then the structure will not be correct. So now we will make the Lewis symbols, one electron here, one electron here, and this has six electrons in its last shell. So two hydrogen atoms, actually they combine with one oxygen atom. And how they are combining now, just see. Start from one side, from this side only, hydrogen, oxygen and hydrogen. This needs one electron. If this needs one electron, it will share one electron with the next atom. If it is sharing one electron with the next atom, it will get one electron from the next atom also, because there will be mutual sharing of electrons. So these electrons are coming in the center of two. So like this, hydrogen will be stable because this has got two electrons. But oxygen has six electrons. One this has got from this hydrogen atom by sharing its one electron. But one more electron is required by O to have stability. And even this hydrogen needs one electron to have stability. So oxygen is sharing its one electron this side with this hydrogen atom. So this electron of O will come in center, and hydrogen, this electron will come in center. And these two electrons of oxygen, these four electrons will remain with oxygen. See, now in this way, this hydrogen is also stable. And the oxygen has four electrons, five and six electrons. One this O has got from this hydrogen, and one the O has got from this hydrogen. So around oxygen here also, there are eight electrons in this circle. So in this way, oxygen is also stable. So now we have H, O and H. One electron pair between this H and O. So one single covalent bond is formed between this hydrogen and oxygen. Similarly, this side also in overlapping, one electron pair. So between this O and H also, there is a single covalent bond. And these four electrons are left with the oxygen. Whether we draw these electrons or we don't draw, it's okay. So now in this case, there are two bonds, but both these bonds, remember, these are single covalent bonds. These are not the double. So because there's a single line, one electron pair this side, one electron pair this side. So actually there are two single covalent bonds between the hydrogen and oxygen, hydrogen and oxygen. In case of water, there are two single covalent bonds which will form. So this is an example of the water formation. Now, next example after this I'm taking is of more than three atoms. Now I'm taking four atoms. Formation of ammonia molecule. Example 5. Formation of NH3. Now in this case, a skeletal structure is, again we have hydrogen atoms here. So nitrogen will be in the center, and around nitrogen on three sides we will place hydrogen atoms. This is the placement of these atoms. Now next is the Lewis symbols. Hydrogens have one electron, while nitrogen has five electrons in its last shell. After drawing the Lewis symbols, our next part is start from one side and see how many electrons are required by each atom to have stability. Now see, hydrogen here has one electron, this needs one more electron. So this and this electron is shared, hydrogen sharing one, so nitrogen also has to share one. And similarly, this side also hydrogen sharing this electron, nitrogen will share this electron. Nitrogen shares this electron, hydrogen shares this electron. And these two electrons are left with nitrogen. In this case, see now, hydrogens are stable with two electrons. And nitrogen is also stable. These 6 electrons and 2 electrons, nitrogen has got how many electrons? 8 electrons in its last shell. So in this way, hydrogen and nitrogen, because there is a one electron pair sharing, so one bond will form between this hydrogen and nitrogen here also and this side also. And these two electrons, lone pair of electrons, are left with the nitrogen. So in this case, there are single covalent bonds, but how many in number? 3 in number. So 3 single covalent bonds will form in case of ammonia. So these are the examples of single covalent bond formation. Now next we are moving on to the double covalent bond formation. Double covalent bond. A double covalent bond will form when there are 2 electron pairs in the sharing. Double covalent bond is formed again by mutual sharing of electrons. But how many electrons are mutually shared between 2 atoms? That is the 2 electron pairs, or we can say in total 4 electrons. A covalent double covalent bond is formed by mutual sharing of 2 electron pairs between 2 atoms. It is represented by double line like this between the 2 atoms which are sharing these electrons. Now, next is the example. Formation of O2 molecule. For this, we need oxygen atoms, 2 oxygen atoms. And now we'll draw their Lewis symbol. Oxygen has 6 electrons in its last shell. So how many electrons are required by the O atom to have stability? 2 electrons. So both these, they need 2 electrons. If both of these, they need 2 electrons, how many electrons they will share? 2 electrons it will share. Because if it is sharing 2 electrons, then only it will get 2 electrons from the other atom. So both these 2 electrons, they come in center here. So each O is left with how many electrons? 4 electrons here, which are not taking part in the bond formation. But these 4 electrons will come in the sharing. And these electrons which are in the sharing are belonging to both the oxygen atom. This also has got 8 electrons. This oxygen also has got how many electrons? 8 electrons in its last shell. So this way both the oxygen atoms, they are stable. But now in the overlapping part here, how many electrons are there? Between the overlapping portion, there are 4 electrons. That means 2 pair of electrons here. And this is shown by 2 lines like this, double line. That means between the oxygen atom, there is a double covalent bond. So this is how double covalent bond will form. By sharing of 2 electron pairs, double covalent bond will form. This is one example. Now one more example for this thing. Example 2. Formation of carbon dioxide molecule. In case of CO2 molecule, there's carbon and two oxygen atoms. So the one that is in lesser number will be in the center and oxygens are around it. Like this will place these atoms. Now next is we have to draw their Lewis symbols. In the Lewis symbols, O has 6 electrons in the last shell. Carbon has 4 electrons in its last shell. So these are the Lewis symbols of carbon and oxygen atoms. Now next after this is the oxygen. Start from this side from one end. O needs 2 electrons to have stable electronic configuration. So if this O needs 2 electrons, that means it has to share 2 electrons. If it will share 2 electrons, then only from this side carbon also has to share how many electrons? 2 electrons. So these two electrons of oxygen and carbon, they will come in the sharing. So we will have 4 electrons here, 2 of oxygen and 2 of the carbon, and 4 electrons of oxygen, they remain as it is here. Similarly, this O also requires 2 more electrons to have stable configuration. So it will share these 2 electrons, and carbon also from this side has to share 2 electrons. So here we have these electrons, and O is left with the 4 electrons here. And all 4 electrons of carbon, they are involved in sharing 2 this side and 2 with this oxygen atom. So no electrons left on the oxygen. So in this way, see, now O has got 8 electrons. This is stable. This oxygen also has got 8 electrons. This is also stable. And carbon also has got these 4 and these 4 electrons. So 8 around this. So this carbon is also stable. So in this way, between the oxygen and carbon, this side 4 electrons. 4 electrons means there will be a double bond this side. Even this side also there are 4 electrons. That means there will be a double covalent bond both sides here. So total we will say there are 2 covalent bonds between the oxygen carbon in case of carbon dioxide. So 2 double bonds, double covalent bonds will form between the oxygen and carbon. So this is about the double covalent bond formation. Next is triple covalent bond. Now how the triple covalent bond will form? In this case, a bond is formed again by mutual sharing of electrons. But how many electrons are involved in the mutual sharing here? 3 electron pairs are involved. So a triple covalent bond is formed by mutual sharing of 3 electron pairs between 2 atoms, and it is represented by triple line. Triple covalent bond is represented by a triple line between the 2 atoms which will share these electrons which are involved in the sharing. Now example of triple covalent bond, to understand triple covalent bond, is formation of nitrogen. Formation of N2 molecule. In this case, there are 2 nitrogen atoms. So we take 2 nitrogen atoms and first we draw their Lewis symbols. Nitrogen has 5 electrons in its last shell. There are 5 electrons. That means how many electrons they need to have stability? 3 electrons are required. So the 2 nitrogen atoms will share 3 electrons. These 3 electrons will come in the center. Both nitrogen atoms are sharing 3 electrons each. So 2 electrons are left with each nitrogen atom. In this way, now see, these 6 electrons are belonging to this nitrogen also and this nitrogen also. So this has got 8 electrons. This nitrogen also has got how many electrons? 8 electrons. So both nitrogen atoms here, they are stable. And in between the 2 nitrogen atoms, there are 6 electrons. That means there is a triple covalent bond that will form between the 2 nitrogen atoms. So this is an example of triple covalent bond formation. Next topic is here, in this only properties of covalent compounds. So those compounds in which there is a covalent bond formation, those compounds are called covalent compounds. So properties of these covalent compounds now. First property is covalent compounds, normally they are in a gaseous or they are in a liquid state, but there are some examples where covalent compounds, they are in a solid state also, like phosphorus, sulfur, they are in a solid state, or liquids generally. Next is, they have a low melting and boiling points in comparison to ionic compounds. Why in comparison to ionic compounds, their melting and boiling points are low? Because as compared to the bonding in ionic compounds, this bond for that is a covalent bond is a weak bond. An ionic bond is a very, very strong bond. So in comparison to the ionic bonds, the covalent compounds, they have a low melting and boiling point. These generally do not conduct electricity. Electricity conduction is because of the free electrons or because of free ions. So normally in covalent compounds, when we take them in pure form, there are no free electrons or ions, so they do not conduct electricity normally. Now these compounds, again, normally they are, generally we can say they are insoluble in water. But some of ionic compounds which can form hydrogen bonding with water, they are soluble in water. So there are many exceptions in these properties in covalent. So we have written these properties which are shown by most of the covalent compounds. So this is the topic, that is the covalent bond formation.